Hi everyone, I'm Carlos, software engineer for Microsoft, and today's video is about showing you how we integrated the BMM150 magnetometer sensor using .NET nanoFramework in C#. In this video, I'll show you and go through the code that we have implemented for you and how we can easily integrate in nanoFramework applications through the sample application that we have. So, what's a magnetometer? Magnetometer is a device used to detect magnetic field strains and are used as compasses. One of the main uses that we have is in mobile phones, just like the one you have. We use it to read the values of axis of X, Y, and Z. For today's video, I will go over the BMM150 sensor, that it's part of this tiny device that you see right here called the M5 Stack Gray, which is an ESP32 device. In the nanoFramework IoT device public repository, there's an implementation for this BMM150 sensor that we will go over it, but the focus is in actually the sample application that we have bundled with it, where you can easily integrate with this sensor, calibrate it, and just get the magnetometer readings very easily. Without further ado, I'll open Visual Studio. The Visual Studio solution is composed by three projects. The BMM150 class library that has all that implementation hidden away from you already sorted out, the sample application, and also some unit tests. The main focus is here on program. As you can see here, it all starts with these three lines of code where we set the bin functions and we also do some specific settings for the ESP32 device that we are using, the M5 stack. Keep in mind that if you use other devices, you might also have to change this. But the good piece is over here actually. So you can see, after referencing that NuGet package, that it's part of the nanoFramework IoT device, you can easily instantiate a BMM150 class, pass a connection into it, and just start using it. The first thing that you need to do is actually perform some calibration. This will perform a series of readings on a high frequency and store those results in a vector. And then those values will be further used when you're actually performing readings on the magnetometer registers in order to perform the right compensation for it. We'll show this in a second. What I'm going to do is going to hit now the start button, and I'm going to show you what happens here with my actual M5 stack device. The first thing you need to do is actually move the device in all directions to perform the calibration properly. As you can see here, you have some duct tape on my device. You really need to be careful with this. But as you can see now, after performing the calibration, we're now getting all those readings. And as I move the device here, you will see, of course, those values changing. So as you can see, it's really easy for you to actually, using a .NET nanoFramework in C#, to easily integrate with the BMM150 sensor on an M5 stack. All of the hard work is already abstracted away from you. And as I mentioned, it's all here on the BMM150 class. It all starts here when we are reading the magnetometer values. The first thing we do is actually read all those values without any correction. So at this point, as I mentioned, you should already perform the magnetometer calibration. And what we're doing here is basically, as mentioned, abstracting away all of the hard stuff, reading those registries, making sure that everything is done according to the spec, and then performing the compensation with the calibration or the calibrated vector as well. And then we return. And that's about it. Hope you enjoyed. Thank you.